so proud of our coaching staff and our players to once again find a way to win. And that kind of personifies our year. You know, just there's ups, there's downs, there's good and bad, but keep on fighting through it, grinding through it, finding a way. Love this football team, our players, their fight, and their determination. And once again, just greatly appreciate our staff for what they've done. Our families, my wife, my boys, all of our family sacrificed a great deal throughout the year and really came here and you know, just wanted to finish this thing right, finish this season right, and that's kind of poetic the way it happened that way, you know, to just feel fortunate to win the game, but also very proud of our players to find it. So I'll open up for questions.
Was the call in the final play to go to the air?
Yes.
Any reason why to deviate from, you know, keeping it on the ground like that?
We had one timeout. So one thing about throwing it, it gives Lynn the opportunity to spring. With no timeouts left, you know, that you know, would be tough. We were thinking about running it before Virginia Tech took the timeout. But I didn't want to because I didn't want to take that option from him to be able to create a pass game but create the play. With no, you know, if we would have run it there and not gotten in and taken the last timeout, that kind of takes, you know, some of that out of his hands for the next couple of plays. So I wanted to throw it right there. Had all the faith in the world he was going to play.
Yeah, that's all right.
Mark, what was it like on the sidelines on that final drive where you're bouncing, the clock's ticking, you're not getting chunk plays, but you're moving it down the field, and you're bouncing your timeouts with time and score? What was it like?
You know, honestly, John, when we took the ball over, I want to say 7:30 or 8:30, something like that, right?
8:25.
8:25, yeah, I thought it was 8:30. And really, in my mind, I was thinking of an 8-minute drive. I really was. Sure, I would take it a chunk play, but you know we're not built that way. But we're also built very difficult to stop in four downs. When he's creating like he is, and when you have the quarterback run game, if you have four downs and stay ahead of the chains, then we're hard to stop. And so I was thinking a long drive there. We had a shot, you know, early. We were thinking about a shot play, but again, I had confidence that we could drive it down and get it in there. And, you know, in the process, kill the clock.
The touchdown obviously was big, but that first catch that Josh had in the drive.
Pardon me?
The first catch Josh had in that final drive on the fourth down.
The fourth down play. Just a huge play. You know, again, Lynn creating and you know, buying a little time and making a tough catch. I mean, that was, obviously a huge play.
Sitting there a while.
Mark, Lynn's basically done everything this year except win a game with his arm. What did it say about him that last play of his college career to continue to do something that nobody expects out there?
Doesn't surprise me. You know, really, just nothing he does surprises me. You know, it's just, you know, everything he does, he competes. He cares about his teammates, and, you know, you can't ever count him on. So proud of him and how far he's come. And you know, if he would have played like that, if we had started him at quarterback, I mean, there's absolutely no doubt in my mind he would be in New York at the Heisman. You know, you can't take away from, you know, Joey and people one and people that were there, incredible players. But this guy right here is one of the best players in the country. He showed that. Of course, he won the prestigious award to Paul Hornung, so deserving for his versatility. And that was on full display. He and I have been talking for years about him playing defense back. He's been ready to go in there. He was even ready today.
Yes, sir.
he can do a lot of things. He really is one of the best players. And I mean that with great respect for all the people that were there. It's just what he's done. And that's what I've talked about. When you're putting the ball in his hands every play, he loves that because the game is running through him. It's running through him on every play. And I don't know. I mean, that was one of the most impressive displays I've seen in a long time. You know, what he did, the way he puts place for him. It's amazing. It's very admirable, and we have great appreciation for him.
Your defense struggled to get stops early on, but after a couple turnovers, you forced field goals. What changed when their backs were against the rope?
It was tough. I had a chance to visit with Justin a little bit just after all the commotion in the hallway there, and that's what I told him. We were off balance, and I think that's a credit to them. He's a very good coach, and they kept some good balance on us today. And it was one of the more aggravating games of the year for us, and you have to credit them. They did some good things and kept us off balance. Our guys, found some stops. And Brad and coaches do a great job always, and our players dug in and found some opportunities, found some stops, but they did a nice job keeping us off balance.
Joe Redford.
Mark, what's it say about the culture of, I guess, physicality you built, but on that last drive, a very good defense, Virginia Tech, 8, 9, 10 in the box?
Yeah.
They couldn't stop you from running?
Well, it's I think, we all know what we're going to do. Everybody in the stadium knew what we're going to do. However, there are some creative advantages when you have a guy like Glenn Plant quarterback. And, it does put a lot of pressure on defenses. You feel like, you have to defend 12 guys, and with him, the way he makes people miss, it's like defending 13. Really. I mean, because with the quarterback and the ability to throw it and just create like he doesn't make people miss, it puts a lot of pressure on defenses.
Mark, what was your vantage point of the incident before the
There was very little discussions with the officials. Other than let's get a hold of this, from the start and make sure we didn't carry that over to game time. And we talked to our players, and they did a good job. We were amped up a little bit early and shot ourselves in the foot with some penalties, and we can't do that. We were lucky to overcome that. They gave us a break for the penalty as well. That extended a drive that led to our first score, if I'm not mistaken. We did the same thing. Let's just leave it at when you're down here for a week and there's some things, there's some crossover and things happen. And these guys are competitive, but we do respect Coach Fuente and their program. We wanted to do the talking on the field today, and we're fortunate to come out on top. But that doesn't surprise me with our guys' competitive nature. So I don't want to get too far into it. Things happen throughout the week, and that just happens. There's not a bowl game, that I've been to that doesn't happen every now and then. We greatly appreciate this bowl. And the leadership from this bowl and our experience here has been wonderful. And we thank everybody.
Second row left.
Coach, recognizing that this is Lynn's last game and all the things that he's been able to do as a Kentucky Wildcat, how hard is it going to be to replace a guy like that next year?
I don't know if you can replace a guy like this. You really can't. You have to build up, get a bunch of good players around him and continue to develop the program. But, the legacy that he leaves and the example that he set for all these young guys, that's what we need to hang on to. I'm not sure you can get another guy like this. I don't know how long we've been playing football at Kentucky. A long time. But he's certainly one of the best that's ever played at the university, and this performance tonight to go out this way is amazing. It just says an awful lot for him, and I'm just so happy for Lynn and all of our players and coaches.
What's your left, Coach?
Mark. Josh Allen, Benny Snell, left legacies. What exactly is Lynn's legacy to the program?
Can we borrow the name Beast Mode from I don't know what we'll have to create one for him, but I just think you just see his competitive nature on full display every snap. Lynn is one tough guy, and on the field, off the field, you name it, he's tough. He's had circumstances in his life that he's had to overcome. He's done that. And we're just very proud of him, but just unbelievable, ultra competitive. The way he plays, it's just great respect.
Second draft.
The kind of drives you all had to win today, those are the kind of things that used to happen with regularity against Kentucky. A winning drive, those kind of just, getting ground out, those are the kind of things that used to happen to Kentucky before, you guys got here. how do you build that mentality to where you don't put yourselves in a position to feel like that's, you know, gonna, it's just inevitable?
Well, I'm trying to gather myself there, but I'm having a hard time understanding your question. But you know, for us, you know, to make that drive at the end to score, to win, you know, I'm proud of that. I'm proud of our players to know that, you know, we can grind it out and need them to go score a touchdown to win the game. And we were able to do that. You know, against the quality team, great defensive coordinator that I have a lot of respect for, great program, and to do that and to, you know, to win in that dramatic fashion, you know, says a lot about our players how far we have come.
Last question for Coach.
Mark, what does it say about Josh Ali in particular, but your receivers in general, that given the role they've had to fill for most of the year, when they got their opportunity on that last drive, they still made those key catches? To
yeah, just, again, it doesn't surprise me. Lynn's done a great job with them. They have respect for Lynn and know that we have to do what we have to do to win the game. And I noticed it even throughout this game. You know, about, hey, just keep on hanging in there, keep on hanging in there. You don't know when they're going to have to go up and make a competitive catch, a 50-50 ball or whatever, and just do it. And, you know, they did it. And, you know, it's what Ahmad just, you know, he and I just shared a hug in there. He's like, I love you, Coach. I love our experience. And I said, man, I'm sorry I couldn't get you the ball. He said, Coach, I don't care. You know what I mean? And that's, you know, you got to love that and have great appreciation for all those guys.
Hey, Coach, thank you.
Thank you.